Hey everybody, I'm Nathaniel Dodson from tutvid.com. Welcome right into this Adobe Lightroom tutorial where today I've got another installment of From Raw to Glorious JPEG. I don't know how many of these we've done now, at least four or five. I've lost count already. And we're going to be doing a natural light photo. These are some photos I shot literally out in the middle of a field. Noonday sun blasting down on our subject. I had no off-camera flash. I had a single reflector as bouncing some light back into her face. And I'm going to show you how I operate and to clean these guys up and get them ready here in Adobe Photoshop. If you do enjoy this video, make sure you go ahead and subscribe to the channel so you never miss any Photoshop or Lightroom or photography-related tutorials in the future. Let's jump into Lightroom now and check this thing out. Well, here we are once again in Adobe Lightroom, one of the best places. One of the best places when Lightroom is moving along at a somewhat reasonable pace and not acting its own sluggish self. Like I said, I've got these photos. These are all natural light photos that I shot, which got a bounce. You can see there in her eyes, just a little circular reflector, a $40 little, Westcott reflector. We're bouncing a little bit of light back into her face, 70-200 Canon f/2.8. What were these shot at? f/4. So, just some reasonable photos. Some of them are not quite as in focus as I would like, but it's more a product of a little motion blur because I was shooting probably 170 millimeters when, why was I shooting at 170 millimeters? I don't even know. So I think I'm going to go with this one here. These are all, one in the same look, so to speak. I'm going to go with this one. We're going to retouch this one. It's not really retouching. It's cleaning it up, and then we're going to spread it across everything else. Now, because I'm picky, I'm going to right-click and choose to create a virtual copy right out of the gate. So we'll work on the virtual copy. It just, because I've already kind of cleaned this image up before, it's just going to make it a little easier for us when we go to preview, do some before and afters and things like that. So we're going to work on the virtual copy here. And I'm going to mess around with this little toy here called Palette. Now, the good folks over at Palette sent me one of these to try out and test out. It's pretty cool. It's super functional, and it's really easy to set up and get used to, and you can do a whole heck of a lot with them. In fact, I found I love just having it even connected to my computer when I'm browsing Google Chrome because I have all these different hotkeys worked into it. But we're in Lightroom today, so let's talk about this. The first thing I would do here is mess around with the basic temperature and tint. And one of the cool things about the palette is I can have temperature and tint mapped to separate knobs here, so I can play around with them both at the same time. See my temperature and tint sliders? They're moving in unison, so I'm like, all right, I can push the tint. Maybe I want a little bit more green in this shot, something around there, and, make it a little less orange. But I can really play with this and say, you know what? That blue-green is really suiting my taste, or maybe it needs to be a little bit more magenta, and as I put magenta in there, bring some orange in and back the magenta off until it's just right. Now, I know I want this right around 5,800 or so, and I just want to introduce a little bit of green. So something kind of like that. So we'll say 5,800 and -9, something right around there. One of the other cool things about the palette, not only are those knobs, but there's also sliders. So I've got this slider set to adjust my exposure. And you can see I can just throw the exposure around really quickly. So I'm going to bump some exposure into this because we're going for really a high key, like naturally lit type of look. I'll also come in here. I don't have any key set to map my contrast because honestly, I usually don't mess with the contrast here. Usually I pump some contrast into this thing over in curves. But, while we're here, we're here. Then I've got knobs set aside also for contrast and exposure both because usually I'm adjusting them with the highlights, shadows, whites, and blacks. So I have knobs for all of these. So I can just say, push some more light into the highlights there. Let's actually bump some light into the shadows as well. Kind of open those shadows up so we can see around her neck a little bit more. And then I'm going to push a little bit more brightness into those whites. Maybe not quite that much. Maybe somewhere right around there. 20-25 looks good. And then should I open up the shadows a little bit more by bumping a little light into the blacks? I think so. I think darkening up the shadows. Well, you know what? Maybe actually darkening the shadows is nice. We'll just put a kiss of black into those shadows just like that. And then we'll come over. I might add a little bit of clarity as well just to give this some nice solid mid-tone punch. And once more, I'll go back to my palette. And here I have a vibrance slider so I could push a ton of color into it. I could drain a lot of vibrance out. Usually I'm working with vibrance, not saturation. I just find you get like more fine-tuned control. So I'll just push vibrance back. I don't know, -9, -10, maybe -11, somewhere right around there will work just fine for us. All right, I'm going to collapse basic. Let's move down here to tone curve. Now for the tone, we're going to introduce more contrast into this. So I'm going to pull a little bit upward up here. This is going to make our brights a little bit brighter. And then I'm going to pull down right to about there maybe. And then this is really almost like a very cool retro style high key photograph, but there's a little bit too much heaviness in the shadows. So I'm going to fade the shadows a little bit by just lifting my black point. I think it just gives me a really cool look. And then I'll adjust the overall darkening just a little bit. Maybe not quite that much fade. That's a little little on the extreme side, and maybe I'll tone down my absolute brightest of whites as well, just to kind of gray off those whites and get this real high key, high fashion look. Now I have a button here programmed on my palette just to give me a quick before and after, so we can see there's our before, there's our after so far. So we're making kind of an extreme change to this, but that's kind of what we're going for, this more stylized look, so I dig it. All right, I'm going to close up tone curve. Let's go down to HSL here. I think I want to take a little bit of color out of the red, mainly because I just think her lips are a little bit too red pink there in the middle of what is kind of a muted photo. And let's say we were shooting this for a clothing brand. We really want that jean jacket to stand out. That's really the star of the show. So we're just going to just take away from the red pink lipstick just a little bit, just to tone that down a little bit. And then let's boost the saturation of the orange just to put a little bit of life back into her skin. So I don't know, plus 25 in the orange department's good. We don't need to mess around with hue or luminance. I think the saturation is the only thing that we really needed to change there. All right, so now we can go ahead and sharpen. Now again, on my palette, I have one slider here dedicated to sharpness. You can see as soon as I touch it, boom, the detail tab opens right up and I get to sharpening. But I want to zoom in and see what's going on. So you can see automatically you can just click and zoom, or you can have a button on your palette that just immediately zooms you right in just like that. And I can get a real good idea of what I'm doing sharpness wise. And, you know, I'll add something kind of like that. And then I'll hold down my Alt or Option key and I'll use the masking a little bit and just mask it back to just the details in the photo and get a real nice little bit of sharpness just like that. Now, I love the camera calibration tools. So one of the sliders on my little palette I have set to change the tint in the shadows, and that's going to swing me from a nice purple in the shadows, magenta really, to like this greenish color in the shadows, which you can see how much it changes the overall feel of the photo, right? Just by changing that one thing. And maybe you wouldn't want to go quite that extreme, but you can go a little bit. I think I'm going to actually push some green into this. I like kind of the organic kind of crusty feeling that it gives the overall photo. And if I wanted, maybe I'll bump a little bit more. You know what, actually, I'd probably go the opposite way with saturation in the red. And you could play around with the greens and blues. I'm going to bump a little bit into the green here and take a little bit out of the blue, something like that. Again, if the jean jacket's the star of the show, you want to be careful messing around too much with that. Let's do a quick before and after. We can see, yeah, I kind of like it. So it's really coming from this sort of much more flat image coming out of camera to we're pumping the contrast and blowing it out over here. Very, very high key. So I kind of like it. Maybe there's a little bit too much green. Maybe I'll actually push that back the other way now that I'm looking at it. I think I might do that. And just right from here, I can use the palette and just go ahead and adjust the temperature. So maybe I want to make that a little bit more orange. Maybe take just a little bit of the green out of there. Take some of the green out. How do I want to do that? Yeah, probably something like that. We'll adjust it. Do what looks good. Obviously, your photo will be a little bit different than mine, but this is more of a stream of consciousness kind of thing where we just play with what we've got going on. All right, I'm going to open up effects here, and I think I want to add some grain. I'm actually going to try dehazing a little bit first. What if I bump a little dehaze into this? It kind of gives me that really deep contrast boost. Let's just hit the little toggle switch here to see before and after. I kind of like that. I'll tell you one little pet peeve I have about this photo is over here. The highlight is so strong on her arm, it's kind of making it disappear. That would probably be something I would take it into Photoshop and clean that up a little bit. But for this, I'm not gonna worry too much about it. I'm gonna zoom back in to 100%, just with my little zoom button there. Thank you, palette. And I'm gonna just bump a little bit of grain into this. There doesn't have to be a huge amount, just a little. Maybe make it a little bit bigger and make it a little rougher. It's going to serve to kind of help blend some of the tones in the skin, and where we have these harsh transitions from the hair to just the stark white sky, it's going to help to kind of clean that stuff up a little bit. Once again, we can do a quick before and after, and we can see we have a radically different image that we got out of camera, and now we've done all of this high key adjustment stuff to it, and I really kind of like it. So we've made all these adjustments to this image, and all these photos are from the same set, so in theory, we would take these adjustments and paste them across all the photos, which you could normally do by like selecting this photo, right? Select this photo first, and we could select the next photo, and we could hit the little sync button, and it's going to say, what do you want to sync? And you could choose what, and then say synchronize. And then boom, we have everything on this photo. Well, I also have one of the buttons here on my palette. Again, I feel like I'm pumping the living daylights out of this palette. You can do all this without the palette. I'm just having some fun with the palette, so bear with me here. We could take this, and I have a button set up to just paste from previous. And essentially what it's doing is up here under settings, we have this paste settings from previous. And our previous photo would have been the photo we edited. So just with the simple click of a button, I can paste those settings right over. So I can just select another photo. So yeah, let's see what this one looks like here. That's pretty cool. Let's go ahead and try this one. Paste those settings over. Now, if I wanted to select multiple photos, like all three of these, I would just select this photo and hold down Shift, select to the end there, and then I would probably still use Sync for this because I can do multiple photos with Sync, whereas Paste Previous, it would just select the first photo in the bunch. So you can see we have just these highly stylized photos, very high key, really sharp, crisp contrast. We played with the color a little bit, and we did it relatively quickly. And once you kind of have this down, and you know you like what you're looking at, and you kind of know what you have in mind for adjusting the photo, you can really, really get some good stuff. And of course, with my little friend here, the palette, I can play around and have a little bit of additional fun and add a little speed to my workflow as well. So yeah, that's pretty much it for this one. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Hope you picked up a thing or two. Again, make sure you subscribe to the channel so you never miss anything in the future. If you did really enjoy the video, you thought it brought you a little value, consider picking up a copy of my Photoshop course. It's all about how to retouch images in Photoshop. If you're a photographer, I think you'll really like it. I think it'll bring you some value, and it helps support what we do here at tutvid.com. And for that, ooh, thank you so much. That's for sure. Also, sort of our pseudo-sponsor today, Palette. They aren't paying me anything for the video, but they did send the Palette unit along. So I just, you know, it's kind of a full disclosure kind of thing that I did get it from them, and I just wanted to kind of test run it a little bit here in Lightroom and play around with it to let you guys see and maybe sort of experience what it's like to have one of these little bad boys. So for doing all of this different stuff in Lightroom, from curves to the basic adjustments that we made, to color adjustments and sharpening, everything else along the way, guys, for this one, that's it. Get it? Got it? Good. Nathaniel Dodson, tutvid.com. I'll catch you in the next one. And before you go, make sure you subscribe to my channel for more great tutorials every day. Also, buy my course. It helps us do what we do, and this channel is supported by viewers just like you. You can also just click the thumbnail and watch another video from this channel. See you next time, guys.